to the Lord. You're watching Clear Vision, and I'm Rose, and I'm here to talk to you today about the way that you can get into fast blessings. God has fast actions, and He has fast blessings. Not all the time, but some of the time, God wants you to be blessed so quickly. And then we're going to talk about today how you can do that, how you can receive the blessings of God in your finances, in your heart, in your mind, in your thinking, in your mind, in your body. I love you. I'll be back in just a minute, and we'll see you and talk about fast blessings with fast actions.
Send your love gift today to receive Living God's Rich Life in Excellence. You can live every day in the excellence, abundant, rich life that Jesus promises in John 10:10. God has approved you, created you as His chosen instrument. Order today, Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, to learn how to apply God's 8 powerful principles that He has established to grow you in His powerful presence and keep you in all of His excellent plans of love and power. Send your love gift to Rose Ministries, Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310, or call us at 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Order your copy today.
Praise the Lord. We're talking about how to take action today, how to bring action into reality. And God, sometimes we get to thinking about all we can do, or what we can do, or how we can do to talk God into things, or talk other people into things, or make things happen in our life. Well, there's an action that we can take that will bring you into great blessings fast. And that action is called expectation. When you expect something, when you have expectation of something, then that puts God into action. Okay? And that's what we want to do. We want to learn how to apply the Word of God in such a way that He is putting things into action for us. We can do all kinds of work. We can stay busy. Law, we got so many things we can stay busy with, and we can keep busy with, and we can get everybody else busy with. But what have we really accomplished? Proverbs 10:22 says, "The blessings of the Lord brings riches without toiling or drudgery." Now, I've read that out of my little book, Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, which you're being offered today. And I want you to order that book. And I want you to order the book at the end of the program called 30 Days, The Champion in You. Both of those little books have rich scriptures in them that are going to help you become all that God created you to be by trusting Him. We get to thinking we've got to do everything in our lives. We've got to take over everything in our lives and make it happen. We start concentrating on the future. How are we going to make this come to pass in the future that we want to see come to pass? How are we going to get past the past? How are we going to live in today? Well, God is a God of peace and calm and comfort and joy. He's a God of grace and mercy. And in Proverbs 22, in the scripture, it says, "The blessing of the Lord, it makes truly rich, and He adds no sorrow with it, neither does toiling increase it." Now that goes against everything everybody's ever probably maybe taught you. You have to work hard. You have to earn your way in life. God says trust Him. Expect Him. Expect Him to be the towering protection that He says He is. Expect Him to give you favor. Expect Him to bestow honor and splendor on you. Expect Him to never refuse His prosperity in your heart, in your mind, and in your life, in your spirit. Expect Him to not withhold any good thing from you. Let's thank the Lord right now. Let's thank Him. Let's say, "Father, thank You that You have so much more in store for me. And Your help makes me break every negative stronghold in my mind that keeps me from your favor. Father, thank you that my birthrights, as your chosen beloved child, I declare and act on expecting more of your great royal love for me, more of your peace for me, more of your power, more of your authority, more of your abundance for my life right now. My Father God, thank you right now. I am your blessed, royal, holy child. I put myself a lot of times under great stress schedules, I call them. And because I put myself under these great stress schedules, I put other people under those kind of schedules. Demands, we got to have this done now. We've got to do this way. We've got to make this happen by this time next week. We have to be here. We have to be there. We have to reach for this. We have to reach for that. Well, God has greater, more supernatural expectations and blessings than I could ever have. His actions will show up when I start believing. I used to stay up through the night worrying, thinking, planning, writing lists, making those million-dollar lists, they call it, for tomorrow. What am I going to do for tomorrow? Daily planning. And daily planners are wonderful to remind you of things that are going to happen or appointments that you have. But, beloved, don't plan your life out to the point that you don't have a life anymore. Decide right now to not let anything decide but what God says. Decide right now, Father, that you're going to let God design your life. You're going to let Him build you a life of victory. Expect God to work in your life even when you don't see anything happening. Expect that He's working. Psalm 37:5 says, when you commit your life to the Lord, expect and require and trust in the Lord, He will act. Oh, I need this message today. I don't know if you need this message today. I think somebody must, because God has me preaching it. But I need this message. And when I would stay up in the night worrying, thinking, planning, one early morning about 3 o'clock, the voice of the Lord was so clear to me. He said, Rose, why are you awake? And I said, well, Lord, I've got a big day tomorrow, a big day for you. And I'm planning that day out. I'm making sure that all of it's going to run right, just the way I want for you. And as I was talking, the Lord said, wait just a minute, I want to tell you something. While you're sleeping, I'm not sleeping. While you're sleeping, I'm awake. And I'm working on your behalf while you're sleeping. Beloved, you can trust God. When you get through watching this program and you are sitting and worrying and thinking, or you were worrying and thinking about things before you started watching, just go take a break and lay down and know that God is doing what He says He'll do for you, which is to provide for you. He's putting things in place for you. He's putting things in place for you beyond your dreams. Don't be a futile if thinker, okay? Become a dynamic, I love you, thank you, Lord, thinker. All right? Start trusting God. Then ask God's help. Ask His help to calm your mind, to calm your heart. You may have been experiencing a tragedy in your family. You may have experienced a tragedy in the life of a loved one, someone else that's not in your direct life. God is still in charge, and we're to focus on His goodness. Pursue His goodness at all costs. No matter what's going on, be eager to live with God, your King. Be eager to trust God to give you more than you can ever dream, more than you need today, more than you'll need tomorrow, more than you'll need forever. Trust Him that as you make His kingdom and His goodness your greatest care, He's going to provide. See, He's your focus. God is your focus. And when you expect Him to do what He says to do, when you draw on His victory for you, when you thank Him that He's taking action on your part, and when you thank Him that He's stepping into situations that you have no idea what to do about, and you're trying to figure it out, when you expect Him to honor His word, to come forth with His word, He will remold your thinking. He will remold your mind. He will start giving you the peace that passes all understanding. That peace is available to you. That calm in your life is available to you. The joy of the Lord that is your strength is constantly, continuously available to you when you take action to expect God to do all that He says He'll do. That word expectation means to require. It means to trust God no matter what. Require Him. Know that He is going to do what He says for you. The greatest action you can take, the greatest step you can take in trusting God is to expect Him. Expect Him to provide for you. Expect Him to take care of you. And He will. I love you so much. And I'm here to talk to you about this some more. So after we get back from the break, I'll see you and we'll go further than we've already gone. I love you so much.
Send your love gift today to receive Living God's Rich Life in Excellence. You can live every day in the excellence, abundant, rich life that Jesus promises in John 10:10. God has approved you, created you as His chosen instrument. Order today Living God's Rich Life in Excellence to learn how to apply God's 8 powerful principles that He has established to grow you in His powerful presence and keep you in all of His excellent plans of love and power. Send your love gift to Rose Ministries, Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or call us at 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Order your copy today.
I'm Rose, and I'm talking to you about how your actions and how you take action and expect things create great, fast blessings in your life. And just as what you expect and how you take action can do that, so also can how you expect if you expect things to happen bad to you or you take action for bad things to happen. I've experienced this in the lives of many people that call into the ministry. They call in and they tell me that they've had a tragedy happen in their business or they're in their job. They may have lost their job, and they're so angry about having lost this job or having loss of some kind in their life. And the next thing they're going to do is take action against the company. Take action against their boss, their ex-boss. Take action against their ex-boyfriend or their ex-husband. They're going to take action against their child. If you take action, you're going to get what you take action on. See, however you think, however you expect, however you take action will be the result of what you're going to get. If you take action that you want to lose weight, let's say, and you start eating right, then you're going to start seeing a change in your body that's for your good. If you take action that you want to exercise and you want to get a healthier exercised body, then you're going to see the results of that. If you don't take that action and you continue to eat and do the things that you've been doing, not being active maybe, eating the wrong things, eating too much sweets or whatever is not good for you, then you're going to see the results of that. Whatever action you're taking is going to result in what the final outcome of what you're taking that action on. So what we're talking about today is how to take action with God. How to take action with Him and make it a habit to see yourself the way that He sees you. God has actions. He takes actions all the time. When He created this great, magnificent, whirling earth hanging in the universe, this island in the sky, I call it, He took action with words by saying, "Let there be." And from the results of His action of His words, earth, you, everything was created. See, that's how powerful we have a Father God. So I think if He can take that kind of action and get that kind of results, I believe I'll just trust Him to take action in my life. There may be things in your life that you need to ask God to put some fire in your spirit over. Maybe you're going to church and you've been going to the same church for many years. And when you go, it's just the same Sunday after Sunday after Sunday. Well, beloved, this next time when you go, take action with God to ask Him to put fire in your spirit. Ask Him to make you excited about the message, excited about your pastor, excited about people in the church that you're there with. Ask Him to help you be excited about your life. I know so many people that don't have any excitement in their life. And then there are others who have way too much excitement of the wrong things in their life. All you have to do is turn on the news every day and you'll see all the excitement you want in people's lives that doesn't need to be there. What kind of actions are you going to take? What kind of actions are you going to take to surrender to the Lord? What kind of safeguards do you want to put up in your life to become the royal victorious heir to the royal kingdom of God that He's made you to be? Well, my favorite way is to speak and to think, because the Lord says, as we speak, whatsoever we say, excuse me, in the name of Jesus, it will be done. Whatsoever we say. If we have a mountain in our lives, God says, say to this mountain. Speak to the mountain. Don't be hollering at God to come and get you out of trouble like Moses at the Red Sea. God said, Moses, go ahead and part the Red Sea. You have the power and authority in my word to do it. Take action. Take action. Speak to the mountain. See, if you have a mountain in your life, you have a mountain of financial problems, you have a mountain of emotional problems, you have a mountain of concerns about so many things, take action to sit at the feet of Christ. Take action and expect God to answer whatever need it is you're asking Him about. Speak to Him about it. Proverbs 23:7 says, "For as he thinks, as a man thinks in his heart, so is he." Whatever you're thinking, whatever you're thinking about, that's what's in your heart. And when you will examine your thinking, when you will examine how you talk, when you get into these little books that I send you, God's Royal Confidence and this one, Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, when you get into the scriptures in these little books, the powerful anointing of the scriptures in these books, you'll see that God has plans for you. God has prepared places for you in the kingdom that are so rich and so high for you to live a life of joy and comfort and trust in the Lord. That doesn't mean you sit around and don't have fun. That doesn't mean you can't ever laugh. It means exactly that. It means that you are to have fun. It means that you are to raise your standards of having a joyful life. Learn to laugh. Learn to obey the voice of the Lord and give him to yourself and to others. Learn to obey the voice of the Lord, knowing that when He's speaking to you, He's speaking to you out of His expectations for you. See, God expects you. He expects you to expect Him to take action on what He says. Gosh, I love this. I love these teachings about the power of God. I love the teaching about knowing that God is going to do what He says. I love the teaching that God has a banquet table, rich, full of all the goodness of His kingdom for you. I don't know what you're experiencing. I don't know what you're going through. I don't know what you've been through. And you may be sitting there saying, but Rose, you don't understand. I've had so much happen to me in my life. Beloved, I don't know what's happened to you, but I do know God. I do know the power of Almighty God. I know that when we expect to feast on God's love, when we anticipate, when we take action to live in God's goodness, that's like sharing the greatest gift that anybody could ever give you. I know we're a long way from Christmas right now. And I know that every year at Christmas, in my family, because I have such a big family, I have a family of 14 grandchildren and children, and more on the way. And they have tremendous expectations right now, waiting for that time in the fall when we start preparing for Thanksgiving and Christmas. They think that way about every holiday, about every birthday. They think that way about every day. I've taught my children and I've taught my grandchildren, get up every day looking forward to the most exciting time of your life. Get up looking forward to God providing for you. Get up looking forward to anticipating to be a blessing to somebody else. I want to bless you by these little books I send you, and I know that they do bless you. So order your complimentary resources of the ministry at the end of the program. Call, write in. Let me be a blessing to you, because I love to bless, and I love to be blessed. God loves you so much. He wants you to know for certain, know for absolutely certain that His unfailing love is pursuing you all the days of your life. He will never leave you or forsake you. When we come back, we're going to have our closing prayer, and I know that God's going to move on your life mightily. I love you so much, and I look forward to praying with you. God loves you. I'll see you in just a minute.
Send your love gift today to receive Living God's Rich Life in Excellence. You can live every day in the excellence, abundant, rich life that Jesus promises in John 10:10. God has approved you, created you as His chosen instrument. Order today, Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, to learn how to apply God's 8 powerful principles that He has established to grow you in His powerful presence and keep you in all of His excellent plans of love and power. Send your love gift to Rose Ministries, Box M, Bergen, Kentucky, 40310. Or call us at 859-748-9961. That's 859-748-9961. Order your copy today.
Praise the Lord. We're just having the best time here today. I'm enjoying probably this taping of these programs today more than I have any that I've ever done. Some days we have lots of laughs and fun, and some days we just really are ministered to by the Word. And today I've been ministered to by the Word. See, because I understand God has a great destiny for you. And the little books that we're offering you, the Living God's Rich Life in Excellence, and and 30 Days the Champion in You, those are materials that God has given me through His Word and with His Word in those little books to bless you, to bring you into the destiny that God wants you to have. God wants you to take action about all that He says for you. He wants you to know the destination. We're going to always be going toward the destination, going toward the destiny of God. But today is the day you can begin. Today you can start all over. You can say, I want to have life and enjoy it. I want to have it in abundance to the full till it overflows. Pray with me right now. Pray with me right now and thank God. Thank God with me that He's given you. Thank God. Thank you, Father, that you've given us, that you've given the viewer today a healthy life. Even though they may have been diagnosed, Father, with some kind of a disease or a situation that's in their life, Father, that they are so unclear what to do about. Father, thank you that you are in control. Thank you, Lord, that you're strong on our behalf. Thank you, Father, that we are destined to live all of our life in great victory and your excellence. Thank you, Father, that not only are we going to get out of debt, if that's the case in our lives, Father, thank you, we're going to be the head and not the tail. We're going to lend and not borrow. Thank you, Father, for that. Thank you for your royal love, Father, that protects me. Thank you, Father. Thank you that you are the provider for me at all costs, Lord. And I can trust you. I can expect you to do everything you've said you'll do for me, Lord. Thank you, Father, that you are the vine. Your Son Jesus is my branch. Thank you, Father, that I choose to go and bear the fruit of your love, your royal kingdom love, Father, today. Thank you, Father, for that. Thank you, Lord, that with all my heart, I love you. And with all your heart, you love me. In Jesus' name, thank you, Father. Amen and amen. I love you so much, and I'll see you on Clear Vision next time.
This month's free offer is 30 Days the Champion in You. Do you want to experience the abundant, rich life in Jesus as promised in John 10 and 10? This simple yet extremely effective daily devotional by Rose is a powerful tool to help you set your thoughts on victory. To the glory of God, God has promised to lead you in total victory as His grand champion in every area of your life.